Hey guys, let's have a look at Brass in the Pocket from the Grade 1 Trinity Electric Guitar Syllabus. What a classic track, another great choice by these guys for their syllabus. I don't think we need to go over this in too much detail before we get to the playthrough, but we should just have a look definitely at the first bar rhythm, which also happens in the last bar. The rhythm is this, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so you're gonna let everything ring. So don't worry about when you're hitting that individual note if the other notes are still ringing on. But you're gonna do a hammer on here, okay? And that hammer on is indicated as a slur marking. So you'll see in the music and the tab, there is a curved line between two notes of a different pitch, which let's just say we've got E going down to D. Obviously, I'm not doing this on manuscript paper or with manuscript lines, but that would be, let's use a different pen for that. My daughter's been using my pens again and they're not got much ink left in them by the looks of things. Okay, so it would look like that. Two different notes of a different pitch. It doesn't matter what the rhythm is, but it is a slur marking and we're going to be hammering that on with the little finger. While the next two notes, there is a curved marking between the two of them in the same bar. I'm not writing the rhythms here, I'm just writing the kind of concept. When you've got two notes at the same pitch with a curved line over them or beneath them, that's called a tie and it's joining those two notes together. We've discussed that before, so let's not worry about going into that in too much detail just now. Let's just have a look at the fingering and the strumming pattern that we will use to play it. So I would be getting myself in position straight away. Now we're going to be in fourth position for this whole kind of phrase over the first line and into bars 6 and 7, where we're doing the A add 9 down to the A sus 2. So you've got the... Okay, so what we want here is we're going to be hammering on. We're going to use our ring finger, then the fretting hand on 6th fret of the G string, and we're going to hammer on with the pinky. And there we're going to do downstroke, upstroke, downstroke. So, and then straight into palm muting. Now, don't over palm mute. A lot of people get this wrong. They'll bring the side of the palm of the hand, hence it's called palm muting, and they'll be too far on the strings. Just make sure you can feel that bridge, okay? Get on the bridge and then slowly bring that on. If you come too far, you see what I mean? It's too muted, coming back, coming back. There we are. Now, it's staccato as well, so I'm properly going to roll on and stop those notes in between so it's more short than just... It's quite hard not to do it. There, so we've got... So I actually bring my plectrum back down and just let my fingers touch. Any way that you can do it is fine. You're not going to be marked on technique unless the technique is negative to the performance. So if you've got your own way of doing it, that's cool. But just make sure you do palm mute and you get that staccato feel. And it's coffee, coffee. And then I'll do it all downstrokes, actually. And then you unpalm mute for the A sus 2. Two palm muted there. So you can see the fingers I'm using are first on the 4th fret of the G string, 3rd finger here, the ring finger on the 6th fret, and then I'm using my pinky for that last note. So then that keeps me in one position the whole way through there. 4, 3, 4, 3, 4. Keeps going, ba 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 bum ba 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 bum. And then you're gonna slide the first finger down, 2nd fret of the G string, and it's like a D shape, but you're going to take the middle finger off to get the D sus 2. Now be careful here that you are strumming only the top 3 strings. For me personally, I think I'd just be doing downstrokes for that. So basically you've covered most of the song there, because even the pre-chorus, you know, very similar kind of idea. So you're going to be using 3rd finger, let it ring, and then... So there I would be doing for those last 3 notes, upstroke, upstroke. You could do another upstroke or a downstroke, doesn't really matter. And then I'm going to come down, middle finger on that 2nd fret. All downstrokes, up, up, down. And then that those two bars just repeat, and that's our pre-chorus. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You're going to do that 1, 2, 3, 4 times, then you move on to your chorus. When you do the chorus, just use first finger and second finger to play that little A triad there, and the rhythm is going to be T, T, and coffee, T, long, 3. Move to the G major 7. Again, being careful only to hit 3 strings. If you do what I did and just accidentally touch the D string slightly, just use the bottom of the palm of the hand just to mute those last strings, these lower strings there, okay? And then you're moving back to that D sus 2. Now, you could either do that with 1 and 3, as if you were doing a D shape with the top note removed, or you could do it with 1 and 2, it doesn't really matter. Whatever you want, down strokes. And then you're into your outro, which again is essentially a verse pattern, but you're going to be doing it loud. Don't forget the palm muting. Okay? You're going to go all the way through. You keep doing that, keep doing that. Just be careful. So it's going to do it 1, 2, 3 times. And then on the fourth time, you only do the first part of the riff. And then you're doing a back to your first bar rhythm again. So that's the whole song. A couple of little markings I think that are worth just discussing just in case. Okay. Obviously the staccato, we've talked about that a lot because it's happening over the palm mute, sorry. So PM equals palm mute. Yeah? PM equals palm mute. If you have a note with a dot above or below it, like that, staccato, cut short, okay, just cut those notes short. At the same time, later on, towards the end, in fact, in the last bar, we have above some of the notes an accent marking, which is a little sideways V above a note like that, okay? That indicates to hit those notes hard, okay? It's like a tiny little dynamic marking, but just for that note, just rock it out. And then above the last minim, which actually started prior, didn't it? Because it started on the quaver of beat 2 on the and, and then that is tied over. So that last bit there, you get the accent on that quaver, and it's tied to the minim, which has a pause marking over it. That's called a fermata, and it just means hold that note out longer than you normally would. So it's not just a strict 2 beats. Basically, listen to the full mix, or the backing track, whichever one you want to play along to, and when that fades out, fade out. Just do it that way, and then you're really strict and in sync with the track. Anyway, that's enough information on that one. Let's get straight on to the playthrough.
I got breath in pocket, got